Hi students, welcome to video number 14. Okay, in this video we are going to discuss a new chapter called Web Technology. Okay, this is our fourth chapter. We already completed three chapters. Okay, then in this section onwards or in this chapter onwards we are beginning a new section called Web Technology. In plus two we are dealing with different languages. We already know one language called C++. Because in plus 1, we already completed C++ language along with tokens and control statement. Everything we discussed in plus 1 itself. In plus 2, we are dealing with other category of languages. C++ is an object-oriented programming language. So next category of languages is web-based languages. Actually, in plus 2, we are dealing with two different sections of languages. One is web-based language and second one is Query language. These two languages we are going to discuss in plus two. So we will start our fourth chapter, Web Technology. Before that, we will discuss the learning objectives of this video or what are the topics that we are going to discuss in this video. First topic is importance of Web Technology or what is meant by Web Technology. Then after that we will discuss how data is communicating with the help of TCP/IP protocol and working of TCP/IP protocol. And next we will discuss the communication technologies that we are using in internet. Or there are two types of communication technologies are available. One is client to web server and second one is web server to web server. Okay, these are the topics that we are going to discuss in this video. Okay, we can start. We will start our chapter first. So, we already familiarized with the concept of internet. Okay, interconnection of network. And also we know the concept of networks. Communication through nodes. Everything we discussed in plus one itself. In this chapter, I already mentioned the chapter name is Web Technology. Chapter name Web Technology means it is relating to internet. So nowadays we already know in everywhere we are using internet. Let us example the single window admission, plus one admission. So in government they are using an online term or online mechanism called single window admission. There also we are using internet. Then suppose you want to book a ticket. Nowadays all are booking their ticket through online. Then we can purchase item through online. That means everywhere we are using internet. So without internet nowadays we can't live because everywhere we are using internet. Especially in this situation. For our education also we are using a virtual platform. For interaction with students, that means suppose we want to interact with all the students, we are using Google platform or Google form we are using. That means these all are virtual platforms. So nowadays it is common familiar, that means it is familiar because nowadays there is no normal class, that means physically we are separate, that means physically we are not in a particular place. So that's why for interacting also we are using internet. So nowadays all the technology, that means education technology is based on internet. The point is this, everywhere we are using internet. Okay, internet means it is a collection of web pages. Website, web pages, then terms, everything we know. These all are relating to internet. So everywhere we are using internet. So how internet is working? With the help of web pages. Internet means it is a collection of web pages. It's a collection of web pages. A collection of web pages means collection of web pages forms website. So that these all are small things that we already know. And also the protocols that we are using for internet interaction. The commonly used protocol is TCP or IP protocol. Commonly used protocol is TCP/IP protocol. What is the full form of TCP? Transmission Control Protocol or Internet Protocol. This is the backbone of network. Okay, this is the backbone of network. So we already know the working of TCP/IP. Transmission Control Protocol is dividing data packets into small packets. And after that it is submitting data in sequence format. Okay, so first we will discuss the working of TCP/IP protocol or what is happening when we are sending a data from sender to receiver. What is taking place when we are sending data from one place to another. So with the help of a figure, I will explain how the TCP/IP protocol is working. Okay, let us have a look at the picture, TCP working picture. What is the first step? In that picture, there are two sections are available, sender and receiver. Sender and also receiver. From sender onwards, actually TCP/IP is working based on three steps. Okay, we will discuss the three steps. First step is TCP break the data into small packets. Okay, large data is dividing into small packet. Once the data is separated, the data packets are transferring to router. That is our second step. In second step, packets travel from router to router over the internet according to the internet protocol. So that's why TCP is working along with internet protocol. TCP/IP, that is the second step. The packets travels from router to router over the internet according to the internet protocol. Then third one is step 3. TCP reassembles data packet to the original form. Okay, so these are the three steps of TCP/IP, or how we are routing of data packet from a sender to a receiver. Suppose we are sending any data from sender to receiver, the actual procedure taking place in network is this three steps. First step, breaking data into small packet, and that data packet is transferring to router. Okay, router is transferring data one by one format, and the final step or the third step, the receiver receives that data into packet format, and then it reassembles that data packets into original format. Okay, so this is happening when we are sending a data from sender to the receiver. This is the communication on web, how we are communicating through web. So the first protocol is TCP/IP protocol, and one more protocol is HTTP protocol. Okay, what is HTTP protocol? Hypertext Transfer Protocol. This protocol is used for transferring web pages from sender to receiver. And one more protocol is there, that is SMTP, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. Okay, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. The name indicates for what purpose we are using this, for transferring mail from sender to receiving station. So with the help of all these protocols, we are communicating on web. Okay, with the help of all these examples, we are communicating on web or through internet, how we are communicating. So TCP/IP is the backbone of network. Without TCP/IP, we can't transfer any data through network. Then HTTP for transferring web pages, and the third one is SMTP protocol, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. So this indicates how we are communicating through web. Okay, this is for communication. There are two types of communications are available in web technology. Okay, two types of communications are available. Okay, that we will discuss what are the two types of communication that we are using in internet. First one is, there are two types of communications are available. One is client to server, and second one is web server to web server. First one is client to web server, then second one is web server to web server, web server to web server. So these are the two commonly used communication mediums, or the two types of communication. First one, what is the first one? Client to web server, and second one is web server to web server. So with the help of example, I am going to explain what does mean by client to web server. The normal procedures that we are using in, suppose we want to access some information from Wikipedia website. Okay, for example, suppose I want to collect some information related to network topologies. Okay, so what do you want to do? First, take any of the search engine. For example, Google you can take. In Google search box, you type network topologies. Network topologies. And then click on search button. Then automatically the first option will come from Wikipedia. So in using our mobile phone or our computer, we are interacting with Wikipedia web server. Web server means this is the main computer that contains all the information. For example, if it is Wikipedia, it maintains a web server. So when we are accessing any pages from Wikipedia, that means we are directly interacting with Wikipedia web server. Okay, so that is the first category of communication, client to web server. How we are interacting through client to web server. Then, in some cases, for example, suppose we are performing online banking. Online banking. In online banking, definitely we require some kinds of information. Like that means confidential information. Username and password you want to submit. If we submit username and password in a plain text format, okay, if we are sending username and password as a plain text, then that means we are sending data without any security level. So we can't use the normal mechanism like HTTP for client to web server. So in that concept, we are using a new concept called HTTPS. Okay, you know the full form of HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol. HTTPS means Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secure. Okay, what is it? Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secure. So, using HTTPS, we can transfer username and password. Username and password. In HTTPS, it uses a new term called SSL. Secure Socket Layer. What is the full form of SSL? S stands for secure. Okay, secure shell. Okay. So this is SSL technology that we are using, that is Secure Socket Layer, SSL, Secure Socket. Next, S stands for Socket Layer, Secure Socket Layer. Okay, that we are using in HTTPS. Mainly HTTPS is used for transferring confidential data. Okay, confidential data. If we are interacting with or if we are transferring confidential data, especially username and password, then definitely you want to use HTTPS. Instead of HTTP, normally it is HTTPS is using. So when we are sending transferring data through HTTPS using secure socket layer, then when we are interacting, the web server will send a secure socket layer certificate. Then we can check whether it is original or not. If it is original, then only the data transmission between client and web server is taking place. If the secure socket layer certificate is original, then only the data encryption is starting, or then only the data communication is taking place. Okay, with the help of a figure I will explain, or with the help of an image I will explain what is happening client to web server when we are transferring username and password. In your textbook, one picture is available. With the help of that picture, I am going to explain. Okay, in your textbook, there is one client server authentication procedure is available. First step, what is the first step? Browser request to start a secure session layer or secure socket layer. Then if the server is ready to transfer secure socket layer, or it is ready for accessing a secure data transmission, it will send a SSL certificate. Okay, SSL certificate. The browser check the certificate and it will check whether it is valid or not. If it is valid, browser initialize an encrypt session. Initialize an encrypt session means it continue or it starts the session or data transmission, it will start. After that, once the session is over, then we can close the session layer. Once the session is over, we can, that means we can terminate the session layer. So first step is HTTP, browser is sending a request. As the response of that request, web server is transferring a secure socket layer certificate. Because in communication in web, definitely we need an authentication. Authentication means you want to check whether we are dealing with the right person or not. So definitely authentication is must. So in case if anywhere we want authentication, especially when we are dealing with username and password, definitely you want to check whether it is a right person or not. For that purpose, we are using secure socket layer along with HTTPS protocol. Then, one more example is there. In your textbook, one figure is there. HTTPS authentication of SBI website. If the secure socket layer is correct, then we will get a authentication message. That authentication message you can see on the screen, because that is an example that is available in your textbook. Okay, so this is the example for SBI authentication. So that is client to web server communication. Okay, client to web server communication. We definitely require a communication medium for transferring data. If we are transferring confidential data, then we are using HTTPS with the help of SSL software. Next one, web server to web server communication. Second classification of web server communication, web server to web server communication. Let us discuss this concept with a real life example. Suppose you want to purchase a mobile phone through online shopping medium. It may be Flipkart, Amazon, whatever it is. Suppose you want to buy a product. So we can place your order. Then when we are placing the order, they will ask cash on delivery or online transaction or online banking. Two options are available. One is cash on delivery. We can give cash when we are getting the product. Otherwise, we can have a online transaction. Online transaction means that means the website of online shopping. For example, Flipkart web server is interacting with bank web server. Okay, both are web server. For example, our account is in SBI Bank. The SBI web server and Flipkart web server is interacting. Okay, that kind of communication is known as web server to web server communication. Okay, what is it? Web server to web server communication. When we are dealing with two different web server. The normally used example is online purchasing. Suppose we are purchasing an item through online using your net banking, or using net banking, or on use your online banking. Then it is belonging to web server communication. Okay, with the help of a figure or with the help of an image, I will explain what is happening when web server is communicating with web server. Okay, what is the first step? In your textbook, one picture is the user placing an order. Okay, user is placing an order. Then merchant's web server is getting the order. Then it requests for payment gateway. Payment gateway means they require payment through cash or through online banking. Then if we are suggesting online banking, then automatically the request payment is transferring to bank web server. Then bank web server will check whether the merchant is original or its authorization is okay, everything is okay, username and password is okay, then it will proceed for transaction. Then it will give a response to the payment gateway. Then payment gateway is giving response to the Flipkart or to the online website site, and then by a result, merchant is getting a server response. Server response means your transaction is ready, you can purchase the item. Okay, so this is an example for web server to web server communication. Web server to web server communication. Both the web servers are interacting without the client. First mechanism we are using, client is interacting with web server. Here, web server is interacting with the web server. Okay, both are different. So these are the two communications that we are using in web. Client to web server, and second one is web server to web server communication. Okay, so hope you understood what is communication on web and also classification of communication on web. So these are the points that we learned from this video. Okay, so what we learned from this video? First section was importance of internet. After that, we discussed about communication on web. Communication on web indicate how the sender is transferring data to the receiver with the help of TCP/IP, or how TCP/IP is working. After that, we learned some of the protocols that we are using in networking. The protocols are HTTP, then TCP/IP protocol, SMTP protocol. Then after that, we learned how the communication is taking place on what are the classifications of web. Classifications on web. Web server to web server, and client to web server. These are the two communications. Okay, hope you understood the concept of communication. Please complete your note. Okay, I am giving two questions as homework. First one, explain the concept of communication on web with the help of a example. Explain communication on web with the help of example. After that, classify, write the classification of communication on web. Two classification, only the main points you want to write. You don't need to write the entire point. Read your textbook and only the main points you want to write in your notebook. Okay, then, thank you.